So today we're going to show you how to wire up your ARB dual compressor to your SPOD. So that includes the power switch and your air locker solenoids. Now, I have tried to search how to do this, and there's not very much information out there to do it. So this is going to be your to-do guide, and follow along. So this video is after you've installed everything. So as you can see, the SPOD is already installed. And the ARB dual compressor is already installed in the Jeep. Now, the blacksmith, we've got the 1-tons and 40s on it, so we actually upgraded the brake booster and master cylinder, so we can't put the dual inside the hood, but it's under the passenger side. Again, this is video that helps you wire everything up from the ARB compressor to the SPOD after it's all installed. So, first thing you're going to notice about your ARB compressor is it comes with a ton of wire, right? You've got these wire looms, you've got the wire looms with another connector on it, which actually connects to all these wires if you have independent switches and don't have a trail rocker or an SPOD system. Now, the first thing you do is take this big wire that has all the switch ones and switch twos and throw it in the trash, okay? All you need to do is take the four wires that you have running from the power from the ARB compressor, and first thing you're going to do is actually snip off the connection. You want the raw wires. You're going to have a purple, a green, which we already have tied up since we only have one ARB compressor within the blacksmith. You have the purple, the green, the black, and the yellow. Okay, now what you're going to do, if you just have the compressor, you don't have any solenoids, all you need, very simple, making it very simple for the SPOD, is just the purple wire. Everything else, the compressor is already grounded. So to make the compressor turn on, all you need is to wire the purple switch or the purple up to one of your hot ends of the SPOD switch. Now, if you have solenoids that run your SPOD or run your solenoids for your air lockers, you are going to need to wire the green and or yellow wire to the hot end of each of your SPOD switches, right? So you're going to need a total of three switches. Solenoids will only take up two, and you'll have your ground wire that we'll show you how to wire here. It will go to one of your grounds on your switch panel within the SPOD. So we're going to go ahead and show you how to just tie it right in. Very easy thing. So all you need really is a stripper, a wire stripper, and a Phillips head screwdriver for the SPOD. You are going to strip. You're first going to cut off your connection, then you're going to strip some wire, and then you're going to feed it through the SPOD into your switches. I'm going to go ahead and take the purple wire to our first switch that we want to run the ARB compressor. Very simple. You take it, you're going to strip the wire, put it into the switch that you want, the hot side of the switch that you want to run the ARB compressor. Tighten it up. And that's all it is. So if you have the ARB compressor only, no solenoids, no air locker solenoids, you're running onboard air or anything like that, this is all you need, right? But since the blacksmith has an ARB air locker, I'll show you. You want to make them nice and tidy. You're going to run those through the bottom just like we did with the power switch. Okay, the colored wire is going to go either the green or the yellow is going to go to your next switch or the switch that you want to run your solenoid. I'm gonna run up the colored wire that you have hooked into your ARB solenoid to run your air locker. You're going to tighten that down, okay? Then you're going to take the ground side put that into your ground side of your switch and tighten it down. Now, we are running an E-locker in the back of the blacksmith and a air locker in the front. So that completes the install for the blacksmith. Now, if you have a second solenoid, what you're going to do is take that second color. So it's going to be the opposite. It's either going to be your green or your yellow, whichever one you haven't hooked up yet. You're going to hook it up to your next switch, right? So this is your third switch. If you have two ARB air lockers and the compressor, this is your third switch. You're going to take that second color into the hot side of the next switch and take your ground. You can splice another ground and connect it to the ground of the third switch. So that's as easy as it is, easy as it gets. This is when you, then we'll go and test it and make sure that the compressor works and the ARB solenoid works so that we're getting air to our air locker. SPOD makes the wiring of your Jeep so much easier. The blacksmith does have the ARB twin compressor underneath the passenger side, so you're going to be able to hear it. So make sure that it works. So the compressor works, and then make sure your solenoid works. Perfect. So just flip them off. So we have completed the install of the dual air compressor from ARB. Now again, as we look at the wires, right, you are going to take just the purple. This is just for the twin. You're going to take the purple and run it to one of your switches, the hot side of one of your switches. It doesn't need a ground because it is grounded already. For your air lockers, you're going to, since the blacksmith only has the front air locker, right, we just need a solenoid for one, you're going to pick whichever wire color you have plugged into your solenoid on the ARB, right? You're going to pick that color. You're going to take it to the hot of one of your switches and then take the ground to the other side, so to your ground of that switch. Now, if you have two solenoids, you're going to have, and we've already got it wrapped up really nicely, but you're going to have the other green. You're going to take that to your third switch that's going to run your second solenoid. And then, you know, you can tap back into the black and ground it if you feel comfortable doing that. And that's probably the easiest way to do it, just to make sure you got really good grounds on all the switches. Thanks for joining us. If you enjoyed this video, please like and share it, and feel free to leave a comment. Come and join us out on Facebook by liking our Facebook page. Follow us on Instagram, and come join the crew on blacksmithcrewoffroad.com, a forum for all Jeepers. And we look forward to seeing you out on the trails.